seasonal or annual disasters. Priorities were women in restoration work, particularly in food production and in housing. They have to be part of that because, as I said, very, you know, often resettlement camps do not consider the needs of women and children. Warning systems that utilize media to reach and tap women's assistance, and women's involvement in response and relief operations. I think just to end this short discussion, next please. Disasters are often occasions of, as I said, desperate and promotes helplessness and inabilities of communities to, you know, to just give up. They're driven to despair and hopelessness. But if one were to include the gender approach and analysis in everything that we do in preparation for these disasters, these occasions can also be occasions to enlighten the community about the value of each and every human person in that community. So participatory approaches are not just, you know, a very, shall we say, automatic response to include women because, you know, the funding institutions will require them, but it also empowers women, you know, over the long term and other marginalized groups of in the community. But it also provides for us the opportunity to transform unequal power relations, whether that be class divisions or gender inequalities, that are so important if the community were to act, you know, as a whole to help mitigate the impacts, the adverse impacts of natural disasters. So I think that overall, I think the relationship between migration and gender might not be so obvious, but when you look at it very deeply, it does make a difference when one includes gender. Thank you very much.